Hi, scientist. Mia is feeling a little down today. She went to visit one of her favorite places, but it wasn't how she remembered it. This first painting is one Mia made a little while ago. Isn't it beautiful? Today, Mia made a new painting. Let's take a look. Scientist, can you compare these two paintings? What has changed? Take a moment to pause and think about it. The beautiful beach Mia remembered has changed a lot. Do you notice all the trash covering the sand and in the water during Mia's recent visit? Scientists, this is an example of pollution. Pollution happens when our Earth becomes dirty and unhealthy from trash, smoke, or chemicals. Our land, water, and air can all be affected by pollution. Pollution can harm people, animals, and plants too. Let's take a closer look at what this means. Mia noticed something on her trip. There are three different types of pollution. Let's take a look at each one. The first type is land pollution. Land pollution happens when trash is left on the ground instead of being put where it belongs. This can make it hard for plants to grow and can make animals sick. Where does this trash belong? Right. Trash can be disposed of in trash cans. Some of these items could also be recycled and used again, like this plastic bottle. The next type of pollution is water pollution. You can see many of the same trash items that weren't thrown away have ended up in the ocean. This can happen in our rivers, lakes, and ponds too. This can hurt animals who live in the water, like fish, dolphins, or sea turtles. Plastic bags can trap animals, and trash can be mistaken for food and make them sick. Do you think water pollution affects us too? It does. Pollution makes water dirty and unsafe to drink, and clean water is very important for our health. The last type of pollution is air pollution. This is when the air gets dirty from wildfires or smoke and dust from factories or cars. It can make it hard to breathe and is not good for people, animals, or plants. Can you see the air pollution in Mia's painting? The tricky part about air pollution is you can't always see it. We can see some air pollution, like smoke from cars and factories, but some pollution, like tiny particles or chemicals in the air, can be invisible, but they're still there. On Mia's trip, she took some photographs of pollution. Let's see if you can spot the different kinds. What type of pollution do you see in this photo? You got it. This is water pollution. Boy, does this river look dirty. This trash doesn't belong here. How about in this photo? Yes, air pollution. What is causing it? Right, you can see it's coming from both our factories and cars. One more. What do you see here? Right, this is land pollution. Waste and chemicals can hurt the animals who live here and the plants that are trying to grow. Scientists, I'm noticing something about all the different types of pollution. Are you? Pollution harms the natural resources we need to live, like water, air, plants, animals, and soil. But good news, there are lots of ways we can help reduce pollution. I'll give you a hint. You can use some of our learning about trash and recycling. Yes! Simply putting our trash in the right place can help prevent pollution. That way, it won't end up in our parks, oceans, rivers, or lakes. You can also pick up trash if you see it on the ground and throw it away properly. You could even sign up for a cleanup day at a park or beach. How does recycling help reduce pollution? Recycling helps reduce pollution by keeping trash out of our landfills. Plus, when we reuse things, it allows us to save natural resources like trees that can keep our air clean. But what about all the harmful smoke and chemicals in the air? What could we do to help with that? We can share rides with others or use buses, trains, and subways so there aren't as many cars on the road. We can also bike or walk when possible, so there is less smoke in the air. Even small actions can make a big difference. So, what will you do to help keep our earth clean? Until next time, keep creating, and I'll see you in the science studio. Hey.